EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the Houston Texans.
The kickoff for Carolina.
And we are underway from NRG Stadium in Houston. This will make it into the end zone. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Start that he was looking for as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Second and 12 at the 23-yard line.
He's going to fire deep for and got his man complete. Touchdown, Houston. Damian Radley, 77 yards. And the Texans have taken the early lead.
If you did know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0.
Brett Marr is set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. From the six. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
At their own 31-yard line.
Scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. And now the Texans are going to stop it as they signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second and 11 now. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. And he is the NFC reigning offensive player of the week. You got to think, all the guys that take the field each and every week, that's not an easy award. Always has to feel good to grab it.
It has to feel great because it separates you, at least for a week, amongst your peers. And for him to separate again, he has to have the same type of a game. That means being explosive off the line of scrimmage and catching everything that comes his way.
Now a first down throw complete downfield. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A big play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game.
Good.
Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at seven. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet.
It's caught inside the 25. Yeah, he's going to get this deep on a Carolina side of the field. A huge play there for Houston. 59 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Now a handoff here to his running back. He will push his way down to about the 14. They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of two.
I know the scouting report on him is that he didn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. From the shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and nine.
It's now third and nine.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
They went with the dive look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs. Blanketed everyone. Took away all the passing angles. Thus, the incompletion.
A 32-yard attempt.
The kick by Maher is good. And it's now 3-0 Texans. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with three.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me more.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll have a gain of three to the 33.
By number 31.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32.
His size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. The gun, Mayfield. And he's got his man in stride, complete.
I need to get my swag right there.
Touchdown, Carolina. Mayfield. A big play there with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front. Still first quarter, two receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to him. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area, wherever he lines up, to at least try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive the end of the kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. They lose the yardage, and of course they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
Throw here on first down. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Zone now. They'll look to throw. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you're a player of his stature, You don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You circle the Pro Bowl. Without a doubt, that's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
Ready for the second quarter from Houston. It's the Texans in possession of the football as they've got it with a second and one coming up. From the shotgun now, here's an inside view. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, it hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And the Texans are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. One in, and he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play there, and they're going to need to come up with something better here on 3rd and goal. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes 3rd and goal. He'll drop to throw. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. From 4 yards out, and the Texans have once again taken the lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And his kick is right through.
Makes the score Texans 17, Panthers 14. To kick off.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. From the 10. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Touchdowns on back-to-back drives. So a very good flow right now offensively.
Hard to slow them down, too, because they are locked in. Feel like the offense coordinator is a little bit ahead of the defensive guys right now. They're beating them to the punch with their play calls. They've got a nice rhythm they're locked into. How can the defense...
And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. And the pressure gets to him again. Bradley Roby, the ex-Buckeye, with a corner blitz in the sack.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Third and long for Mayfield. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he can only manage to take this thing to the 38, well shy of the first down.
There's another example what defensive coaches constantly preach, not allowing any run after the catch. They gave up a few more yards than they wanted to, but they were able to get him down quickly and force a fourth down.
And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says.
The Texans take over.
He says out at the 8-yard line.
At their own 8-yard line.
So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they have to be pleased with the way that they moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
On the tackle.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Ashton Davis. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
They'll take over first and 10.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Following the interception, Mayfield rolling to his right. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. And a give this time to the tailback. And he's going to ball his way in for a Panther score. A great play there with touchdown number 12 on the year as his guys are able to regain the lead. And this one through the uprights and good.
Panthers 21, Texans.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start to... The Panther rush, too strong. They get there and take him down. Josh Allen in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
As he throws there, incomplete.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He's going to fire deep for Radley. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
It's another OSCE, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. OSCE tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the OSCE, maybe not a touchdown, but, boy, he's playing really well.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a third and three. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Third and short yardage. Mayfield completes it to Samuel. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. They go play action. Mayfield taking a shot for Samuel. This is caught inside the 15. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Steps away to his left. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
And incomplete. It leads to second and 10.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. And again, it's Mayfield. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers.
Complete to
an 11-yard touchdown. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
And that's certainly an important score right there because they gave themselves a two-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better, too, having that lead.
Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. The kick by Marr is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. A lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Second and 12.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
Alert, alert, alert. Hey, alert, 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 alert.
Mayfield down. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
First down, Carolina.
And he'll give it here to his running back. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. To throw now on first down. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Give the sack to David Onyemata, the product of Nigeria by way of Canada.
Second down.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. He's letting this one go for Fuller. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Houston. Will Fuller, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Texans cut into that lead. The 21st pick back in the 2016 draft, Will Fuller, and we know that he can take the top off of a defense.
He certainly can, and the way that he does it is just straight, pure speed. And I talked with one of the better defensive coordinators in the league, and I said, how do you defend that? And he said, at times, you absolutely don't. If the quarterback gets time and he heaves it downfield, Will Fuller's going to outrun any coverage you put out there.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. He finds some way to turn this into positive yardage as he struggles forward for a pickup of about two.
Brings up second and eight.
Mayfield, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Mayfield off the play fake. And that will be incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Now they had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought process going into it is, hey, if you have to be methodical, go ahead and do that. But what you really want are a couple of big plays. Eat up chunks of yardage and cut down the number of times you have to snap the football.
Second and 9 now. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. After the sack, they'll come up now, 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Jordan Evans providing a little deja vu, back-to-back sacks, and now they're staring at a 4th and long. And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick. Nearly a huge return, as it is still a very good one. 24 yards, and this offense set up with a very short field. 1st and 10 inside the 20. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. A solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special runs in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a 2nd time.
It'll be a gain of 2 on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with 3rd down looming.
3rd and less than a yard.
Now they try the right side here. And he picks up the 1st as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
He's tackled at the 7-yard line.
They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a 1st and goal. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal. They'll try to throw here. Mayfield. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things? Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain of 37.
The dynamic duo is doing damage in this one, and they've certainly been on point throughout. And they hook up again for another big play.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Back to throw. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And he's got four down inside the 20 to the 18. The Panthers on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This time they face a third and two. That's out to the left and complete. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is... is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time? That maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And their four-game win streak very much in jeopardy as they go to work here late with a first and 10. Escaping the pressure right. And incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Incomplete.
Well, so far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. And that brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
On third down, he'll drop the throw. And that is incomplete. Another incomplete pass there. What do you take from this game offensively?
Well, you know it's tough to really analyze for them because it is a team game, right? And let's be honest, though. The defense did them no favors in this one at all. Offense actually moved the ball. So, bottom line, film session, defense, it's going to be a real tough one for them. Offense, they'll get a little bit of praise.
Got an open man. It's Rantley. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41.
Down at the 41.
They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to Huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Out of the gun now on third down. He's going to fire deep for Radley. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And a great return as he takes this up just shy of the 45. Keep in mind, he had the 3-interception game last week, so we requested to talk with him this week. He was all smiles. He's still all smiles.
Yeah, we didn't jinx him at all, did we?
No.
Because ordinarily that happens, things fall off, but not in this case. I think a lot of it goes back to his technique, his ability to see the quarterback throw the ball while understanding where the receiver is running his route allows him to make a lot of plays on the football, and he's taking it away at a really...
He's got the lane, and there he goes.
What you doing out there, boy?
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. His third touchdown of the game, number 14 on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And that'll increase their lead to 28.
Makes the score Panthers 55, Texans 27.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get it. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. On the corner blitz that time, the sack goes to Denzel Ward.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. The veterans, Stephon Gilmore, able to break that one up.
It certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
The Texans on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This will be third and 19. On the give, this is their fullback. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. The Texans send the punter out as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Taken on the midfield logo. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, pulled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now.
Another good run for him. What else is new? That'll put him right at 150 yards for the game. So he's really made his presence felt in this one.
And this one is right down the middle. And that will just add 3 more to a lead that's already out of hand. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. 5-yard line. And they will take a knee here. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
And they'll indeed take a knee. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long.
Hey, check Mike 21, Mike 21, check Mike 21. Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D.
Explosion help leading them to victory, and the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week, we'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Panthers, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1. And they will head home next week to take on the Minnesota Vikings. Meanwhile, for the Texans, it was a good first month, but they'll fall to 4-1 as they suffer their first loss. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Tampa to take on the Bucs. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Did that splash, did that drill, yeah, champion, yeah.